Good afternoon. I'm very glad to open the conference in the presence of our president, Professor Itamar Rabinovich, who will say a words of welcome to the guests. Please, Itamar.
Shalom, good afternoon. First, words of welcome to my teacher, Professor Chedva Ben Israel.
9-2.
Yours too. I studied history and Middle Eastern history at the Hebrew University too many years ago, at a time when the teachers were younger than the students. No, seriously, that's Hebrew University at the time, as I hope is the case now, had a wonderful department of history, and Professor Ben Israel was one of the senior faculty members in the department, and it for me was a very important formative experience. So I'm delighted to welcome you personally and specifically here. The issue of ethnic conflict or conflict in divided societies is of course central to our own life. And when we study, first of all, Israel itself, a divided society, first of all between a Jewish majority and an Arab minority, an issue that has yet to be addressed squarely by the Israeli government and by the Israeli political system. And secondly, the Israeli majority itself divided, I guess, say, along ethnic lines among communities or ethnic groups coming from various parts of the world, with ethnic tensions governing important issues in Israeli politics and other lines of division. And we are surrounded by countries that are also ethnically divided along sectarian, communal, national lines. As a professional student of the modern and contemporary history of the Middle East, I've always found the issue of what we called, when I was an undergraduate student, minorities in the Middle East to be the single most interesting issue in the modern history of this area. Islam is a dominant ideology, was succeeded by Arab nationalism. Arab nationalism in those formative years was pan-Arab nationalism. It just assumed that all Arabs were members of the same nation, but in practice a Sunni ascendancy was accepted, and minorities like Christians, Shia, or sectarian communities like the Alawis and the Druze were actually not considered equal members of the Arab nation. And their quest for equality led to some of the more interesting ideologies developed in this region in the 20th century. If you look at practically every ideological party, communist, Syrian nationalism as distinct from Arab nationalism, some of the more interesting Palestinian parties, you will find mostly members of the minority communities who are looking for a definition of the political community in which they could be accepted and fitted as equal members. And of course, everyone familiar with modern Jewish history would immediately think of Jewish history in Eastern Europe, where in the forefront of ideologies such as communism in countries like Romania, Poland, Russia, you'd find Jews who were, again, looking for a definition of the political community in which they could be fitted, and so on, and so on, and so on. So this has been a cardinal issue of our life and politics, and the social sciences have traveled forward. We no longer speak about minorities in the Middle East, but we speak about ethnic divisions and use more contemporary, more adequate terminology. We also know that you cannot just look at the Middle East, that the broader comparative perspective is important for us and likewise important to specialists in other regions of the world that can look at the Middle East rich in experience, rich in literature, and reflect back on their own society. So I'm confident, given the list of participants, their expertise, and the topics addressed in this issue, that it would be of benefit, and why it would make a lot of sense to look at the platform stretching all the way from Australia and the Pacific to Israel and the Middle East. A word about the sponsoring entities at Tel Aviv University, to the guests. The oldest is the Tami Steinmetz Center for Peace Research that goes back to the early 90s. it's been established in order to study peace in general, but has obviously focused on our issues and soon enough came to deal with divisions also in our society. It was subsequently reinforced by the Evans program in conflict resolution and management, since Professor Yao moved from being the director of the Tami Steinmetz Center to the founding director of the Evans program. Transition has been seamless, but it's visible. And finally, the Daniel S. Abraham Center for International Studies. The word studies has been chosen deliberately. The idea was not to establish at Tel Aviv University another center for the study of international affairs. We have several of them, but to establish a center that would first of all deal with studies and would foster teaching programs, doctoral programs, graduate programs in these areas, but also engaged in activities that Centers for International Affairs sometimes engage in, such as this conference. It's headed by Professor Anand Rein, the Vice Rector of the University, historian of Latin America, itself an area rife in ethnic and other divisions. I'm delighted on all these counts to be able to greet you at the opening of this this conference, to thank our sponsors from abroad, and wish you the most interesting and useful discussion. Enjoy the rest of the day.
Thank you very much, Itamar. I also want to extend special welcome to my teacher, Hedva Ben Israel, Itamar, and myself, were students in the same department in the same years. Professor Ben Israel has not only been my teacher, she was my supervisor in my master thesis, and I owe her more than she knows. Thank you. Now I'll go through my more formal stuff. Well, it started with Professor Rabinovich, but he's not here. So, Mrs. and Mr. Luria, the participant in the conference, dear guests, it gives me great pleasure to take part in the opening session of this conference, which is the culmination of a long endeavor. The conference is a joint venture of the Daniel Abraham Center for International and Regional Studies, the Evans Program in Mediation, Conflict Resolution, and the Tami Steinmetz Center for Peace Research, all from Tel Aviv University. I am very grateful to Professor Anan Rein and Professor Ephraim Yar, the respective heads of these academic units, for the fruitful and pleasant collaboration. I owe special thanks to Professor Tamar Herman, my partner in the Tami Steinmetz Center, who has been with us from the beginning and who took over from me the coordination of the organizing committee while I was enjoying a semester in Venice. I also wish to thank most heartily Yael Carney Alon, the secretary of the Tami Steinmetz Center, Beatrice Ilan, the secretary of the Daniel Abraham Center, Tami Chai, the secretary of the Evans Program, and Marcelo Scheitman for the contribution to the organizing of the conference. All this, however, would have been in vain if not for the generous financial assistance and collaboration of Mr. David Luria from Melbourne, Australia, who represents the Cullen Capital International Bankers and B2B lawyers from his home city. David has been with us all the way and is with us today. His generosity is matched by his knowledge of and interest in the subject of the conference and by his keen desire to contribute in this way to the resolution of conflicts in our global village. He has earned our respect, our thanks, and our applause. Thank you, David. In a way of introduction, I would like to read out the gist of the concept which informed us in conceiving the conference and which was sent to the prospective participants. Very few states in today's world are culturally homogeneous or form what may be termed pure national states. Most states are multi-ethnic or multinational. The ethno-national resurgence in the way of the collapse of communism has brought this salience of global reality to the attention of both academic and political actors. The growing globalization that was expected to serve as the big homogenizer has had, in fact, mixed effects on ethno-national particularisms. On the one hand, we are witnessing the growth of transnational communities, multicultural citizenship, and the emergence of the European Union as a supranational polity. Yet on the other, inter-ethnic wars, ethnic cleansing, even genocides have brought to the fore the devastating potential of the contradiction between the nation state and its constituent ethnic communities. From the point of view of the stability of the world interstate system and the consolidation of appropriate political order in particular states, the resolution of this contradiction has become one of the foremost challenges of the academic and political communities. The balance of the academic approach to the phenomena of ethno-national identity and assertion has been rather negative. Perceived as irrational and malevolent, it has been considered inappropriate as the organizing principle of the state in the modern progressive world. By also informing the attitude and conduct of important global actors, this approach has become a self-fulfilling prophecy. The conference will seek to provide a modest contribution towards revisiting the conventional wisdom regarding ethno-nationalism and ethnicity and their interaction with the modern state. Ethnicity and ethno-nationalism are genus face in their political manifestations. Rwanda, former Yugoslavia, and others present the very dark side of these phenomena. By contrast, in many multinational, multi-ethnic states, from Switzerland, Spain, Belgium, down to many former communist states, the spirit of peace and accommodation has prevailed. Thus, politically, ethnicity and nationalism are not necessarily evil. Their particular balance sheet is determined by the interaction between them as ideologies and identities, and the particular historical, economic, social, and social contexts in which they unfold. The conference will focus on this interaction. An attempt will be made to locate the politics of ethnicity and nationalism along the continuum between violent conflict and peaceful accommodation. For this purpose, we have assembled an impressive group of scholars from near and afar who will do, I'm confident, justice to this weighty subject. As it invariably happens, there have been two last-minute cancellations, and they are not evenly divided, the two being participants in this afternoon's sessions. Professor Avineri and Professor Cejas will not be with us. I'm sure, however, that the rest of the participants will fill the gaps. I wish us all a successful and stimulating conference. Thank you.